Hello, I'm Chloe and I'm a senior physiotherapist from Balance Core, and today I'll be talking about headaches. If you're experiencing pain at the back of your head, at the side of your head or around your eye region, this video is for you. The muscles that are usually responsible for headaches are found around the neck region as well as underneath the skull. So today I'll be showing you how to relax, release or stretch these muscles so that you can help yourself at the comfort of your home. So first up, the first muscles that I'll be showing are the suboccipital muscles, and these muscles are responsible for actually poking your chin forward in what we call the forward head posture. So if you find yourself doing this very often, you have to try to reduce or avoid this movement because that can cause unnecessary tension onto these muscles. So now I'll just teach you how to locate these muscles. To actually locate these muscles, you will first need to put your finger onto the base of your skull. You will feel like a bony ridge, and I need you to come underneath the bony ridge to feel something that's a little bit softer, and these are your suboccipital muscles. So place your finger along the line and just try to press and feel any aching or tender spots. And if you do find one, just allow your thumb to come deep and press within the muscle with a very firm pressure. What I find really helpful to release these muscles is that you actually need to use your other hand to give a stabilizing force, and that will actually help you to relax further. So if you can put your hand over at your jaw region here to actually give a little bit of a gentle chin tuck by bringing your chin closer to your throat, try not to do this excessively, and it shouldn't look like this, otherwise you'll be tensing the side of your muscles. Just do a very gentle chin tuck with the help of your other hand, and then just place your thumb again on the same location that we've identified before. And I just want you to do this kind of movement. With your hand that's stabilizing on this side, it's actually easier for you to relax your muscles. So the next muscles that I'll be going through are the muscles that are responsible for biting or chewing, and these are the masseter muscles that are found at the side of your cheek and the temporalis muscle that's found at the side of your head. So the masseter muscles, if you want to locate them, they are actually found just right over here, and what you can do is you can just gently clench your teeth and you can feel a little bit of a tension just by the side here. Okay, so if you do feel that your headache is also associated with like ear aches or like popping and clicking around the joint or around the joint of the jaw region, this may be because the muscles are very tense over there. So I just get you to place your finger right at the jaw, the mandible area, and you can actually sink your finger in and allow like a pushing and upward movement to actually stretch the muscle. So just be mindful that when you're doing this exercise, do not clench your butt onto your teeth. You just want to allow your mouth to have like a small opening, so then that will be relaxing for the muscles. And you're just going to hold there and just wait for the pain to actually subside. Or when you do feel that there is like less aching over the area, you can just move on to another spot along around the same area. Okay, the next muscle that we'll be going through is the temporalis muscle. So to locate this muscle, you can again clench your teeth together and you can just feel that there's some tension and tightening and hardening of that area there. Find that area, that spot, and you can place, actually do this on both sides as well, and it's really quite relaxing to do so. And you can just allow to pull up like there's a stretch. And breathe and relax. And I really like this stretch because it's really comfortable and relaxing. And relaxed. Good. So really, just try to make sure that when you're doing these exercises, you do not just do it superficially just on the skin. Otherwise, you'll just be tugging your skin up and down. You just have to make sure that your fingers are really sunk deep within to reach the muscle layer before you start to drag and pull them up. Yep. So the last muscle that we'll be going through today, they're also responsible for headaches, are the scalene muscles. And we have three pairs of scalene muscles, and more specifically, the one that I'll be going through today is the posterior scalene muscles, because these muscles are usually associated with tightness of the suboccipital muscles. So to locate this muscle, I'll first ask you to elevate your shoulder blade, your shoulder, in this manner, and you'll see that you'll start to contract the upper trapezius muscle over here. You won't miss it because it's really obvious. What you need to do is just to place your finger just right in front of the muscle, and I would need you to just dig slightly underneath. So just in front of the muscle and just dig slightly underneath it, and I want you to press a downward force. So what you should aim to do is to allow the depression or the lowering of your shoulder blade, as well as if you want to increase the stretch, you can allow your head to actually fall nicely onto the other side, and just feel that your ear and your shoulder, the distance is actually increasing as you are gently just relaxing this muscle. Just make sure that when you're doing this as well, you're doing like a forward chin position. Always maintain a very slight chin tuck, and that would be excellent. So I've covered all of these 4 muscles that you can do for yourself. If you find these tips useful for you, feel free to comment and share with us down in the comments box below. And for the next video, we'll be sharing a little bit more about what exercises you can do at home when you're sitting for a long time in front of your desk. And thanks for listening today.